Apple's ecosystem tries to cover every single aspect of your life, and that includes a password manager app, aka iCloud Passwords. But is it actually good to keep all your things in one boat? First off, some context. The iCloud Passwords app is not a new thing. It's just an evolution step of the iCloud Keychain tool that previously resided in Settings. Apparently, enough people used it for it to become its own app. Honestly, I went into research expecting to be severely disappointed with the Apple Password Manager, but I actually found quite a few good things about this tool. For one, it has a very convenient setup. The Passwords app is built into Apple's device. You just gotta search it up, or if it's not there, grab it from the App Store at no cost whatsoever. It looks pretty neat too, clean and minimalistic, so it is easy to get used to. There's a few categories here. One where you keep all your passwords, one for pass keys, one for verification codes, and this one was really nice, a section for Wi-Fi network information. It automatically saved all my known networks with their passwords. Just pulled the info from my Mac as soon as I opened the app. And then you've got a security tab that points out weak and reused passwords. It's standard password manager app functionality, but it's nice that they bothered to add it. Now, if you want your password field to be filled in automatically when browsing, you're pretty much set with Safari. Though it does require a little bit of setup with each website, at least if you want to use this function more smoothly. But if you use another browser, you need an extension. It does the job, but you can see that it has very mixed ratings. I'll talk about why in a minute. As for the security side of things, iCloud Passwords uses the standard AES 256-bit end-to-end encryption to secure data. But me saying this in the Apple Password Manager Pro section is like giving a kid a prize for just showing up to a competition. Participation prizes for everyone. You get a prize! You get a prize! You get a prize! Everyone gets a prize! Okay. Every single reliable password manager has this. Now, if you look behind the initial charming simplicity of this app, there's much to be desired. See, if you put a ton of password entries in here, they all end up in the same tab. There's no option to categorize them or put things into folder. Maybe I'm a little bit spoiled by premium password managers, but this was a bugger for me, especially since all my work and personal passwords ended up in this single space as well. Second, you can't store credit cards or personal info here, and boy, did I miss that functionality. It is so nice to have your credit card stuff auto-filled when shopping, and to not have to add your address manually each time. I also missed a dark web monitoring tool that most of the best password manager options have. It's a feature that watches out for leaks related to your accounts and tells you what information was leaked, so you can then swiftly secure your affected accounts. It's a bit sad that Apple, who's so vocal about being protective of data, doesn't offer this function. The opposite, actually. It turns out that they're not as secure as they made it out to be. The Passwords iOS app has a serious vulnerability that lasted 4 months. Thankfully, that was patched up with the 18.2 update, and I didn't find any other issues so far. But the fact that they let this slip through is not very encouraging. What's more, since Apple is pushing you to use only them, that often means that most, if not all, of your devices are in the same ecosystem, aka all of your eggs are in one single basket. Or your apples in the same basket. Sorry, pun intended. Anyway, if one of your Apple devices gets lost or stolen, all of your stored logins and account information can be accessed with just your passcode. But if you do use other devices, then the iCloud Password app becomes somewhat inconvenient. There's no app for Android or Linux, though you can kinda use it on Windows through the iCloud app. That said, your best bet would be to get a browser extension on whatever you're using. But the autofill is buggy, and apparently it just straight up doesn't work for a lot of people. I mean, look at this sad, sad rating. Overall, I'm not saying this is a horrible password manager. It's decent and a good starting point, but very, very basic. So I am sticking with my third-party password manager. If you want recommendations, I will put links to my tested and trusted options in the description down below. Those links will also apply the latest discount, so you can get really great deals. But what do those password managers have that Apple doesn't? Well, let's take a look at NordPass and 1Password as an example. These are two of the most popular options with strong security backbone, frequent audits, and and an array of security features. Still, the apps themselves are very, very easy to use, especially NordPass Password Manager. It is my best recommendation for beginners as it is incredibly simple and intuitive. Plus, you can use these password managers on any device that you want. They have very nice browser extensions too, though the 1Password extension does tend to be a little more buggy compared to NordPass. You know what? You can basically take any con I mentioned for the iCloud password app, and it's not an issue with these two, especially when it comes to features. Both work great for form filling, be it addresses or payment details, and both have excellent tools for data leak monitoring. It actually saved my butt a few times. Plus, I can also share my passwords easily, something the Apple Passwords app also can't do. And I can even share whole folders with 1Password. Oh man, the folders. How I missed these after my iCloud Passwords app test period. It is so nice to organize your stuff. I'm going off on a tangent here, but the point is you can expect much, much, much better functionality from 1Password and NordPass premium apps. And they aren't a huge investment either, less than a couple of bucks per month. Just if you want the most savings, don't forget to grab the discount code through the description. And if you're still not sure, there's a limited NordPass free version to try, while 1Password gives you a mandatory free trial when you're signing up. However, I will say, if you want to use the iCloud Password Manager, then use it. Is it the best password manager for iPhone or Mac? I wouldn't say so, but it's good enough. It's also a great starting point of getting your parents and grandparents to use a password manager, at least once you're over the stage of convincing them that a single password for everything is not a good idea. Anyway, let me know your take on the Apple Password Manager in the comments section. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to drop a like and a subscription. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.